Last once again, good morning to one and all. Last class we had discussed regarding the positive clampers. Okay, we had seen the positive clamper, how the output waveform will be for a square wave and for a sinusoidal. These two we have seen in the last class. Okay, today class we will discuss the regarding the positive clamper with reference voltage. We have a reference voltage. Okay. If you place the reference voltage, how the output waveform will be. For this one also, we will discuss for the sine wave and also for the square wave. Both we are going to discuss. Okay, we will see the how the output will be. First, we will go for the sine wave. Okay, suppose if you apply a sine wave of peak to peak. Of peak to peak 10 volts. Okay, if we apply a sine wave of peak to peak plus 10 and minus 10, and if we have a reference voltage of 3 volts, reference voltage of 3 volts. Okay, this is your reference voltage. Okay, let it be this is your reference voltage 3 volts. Okay, now how the output waveform? This is a positive clamper. Okay, we observe the previous one. It will be same as the same direction. Diode will be in same direction. Okay, cathode will be top side, anode will be bottom side. Okay, for this waveform, here we have connected a reference voltage. Okay, and one more thing we have to remember: if we interchange the polarities, okay, if we interchange the polarities of this battery, okay, reference voltage, then automatically the output waveform will be changed. Output waveform is going to be changed. Okay, therefore the polarity is also important. Okay, if the positive is connected to the anode and negative is connected to the ground. Okay, in this case, if you interchange these polarities, automatically output waveform is going to be changed. Okay, then for this type of waveform, if we apply a sine wave, if the input voltage, okay, that means at t equal to 0, input voltage is 0. Okay, at the time of starting, input voltage is 0. Okay, that means for the cathode, we have applied the input voltage 0. And for the anode, 3 volts we had applied. Okay, 3 volts. Therefore, diode will be in on state. Okay, diode will be in on state. And here it is 0 volts. And here it is 3 volts. And this will be a positive terminal. And this will be a negative terminal. And the supply will be flows in this direction, because always current flows from higher polarity to lower polarities. Okay. Yeah, when the supply voltage is less than 3, well, this battery is going to supply the voltage. Okay, therefore this will supply the supply voltage, or capacitor starts charging in this direction. Okay, this is plus and this is the minus. And in the capacitor charging path, this is the capacitor charging path. Okay, this is your capacitor charging path. In this path, there is no resistance. Okay, therefore time constant will be 0. Time constant is 0 means the capacitor will charge to peak value. Your peak value is 3 volts. Therefore, capacitor will charge to 3 volts. Okay. I am explaining the when the input voltage is less than 3 volts. Okay. That means if suppose it is at 0 or 1 or at 2 or 2.9, up to the 2.9. Okay. That means input is sinusoidal, it is slowly increasing. The input voltage is slowly increasing. And when the voltage is less than 3, this diode will be on, because the anode is fixed to 3 volts. Cathode is having lesser voltage when compared to anode. Therefore, diode will be on. When diode is on, the supply will be in this direction. Therefore, cathode, we are going to get plus terminal, minus terminal. Capacitor will charge to 3 volts. Okay. This is up to the 3 volts. Up to the 3 volts, we are going to get like this. Okay. And then after 3 volts, okay, what happens? Okay, that means if the supply voltage is at 4, okay, or 3.1, okay, if I take it as ideal diode, when it is 3.1, okay, here we are going to get the 3.1 volts, and this is 3. Therefore, this diode will be off. Once this diode is off means it is nothing but an open switch. Okay, the diode is off means it is nothing but an open switch. Okay. Therefore, there won't be any current flowing in this direction. Now, if we observe this capacitor supply voltage, these two are in series, because minus is connected to the plus. Minus is connected to the plus minus terminal, minus of this capacitor terminal is connected to the plus terminal. Therefore, these two are in series. Therefore, the output voltage, now the output voltage will be V in plus 3 volts. V in plus 3 volts. That means if the input voltage is at 4, then 4 plus 3, you may get 7 volts at the output terminal. When input is 5, 5 plus 3, that means you may get the 8 volts at the output terminal. That means from the after the 3, the output voltage is input plus 3 volts. That means it may be like this, okay? It may be like this. It may move input voltage plus 3 volts. That means this peak value will be at 13, okay? Because our input voltage is 10, okay? When input voltage is 10, we may get the output has 13 volts, okay? We may get the output has 13 volts, okay? This is the output terminal. We are in the positive cycle up to the 3 volts, okay? Once again, when you get the voltage less than 3, when the input voltage is less than 3, then what happens? This diode gets on once again, okay? When the input voltage is less than 3, this diode gets on, and output voltage will, when this diode is on, okay? When this diode is on means here we are going to get a short circuit. When this diode is on means output voltage will be 3 volts, okay? Therefore, output voltage will be maintained 3 volts, okay? When it passes to the negative cycle, when it passes to negative cycle, or when it is input voltage less than 3 volts, diode gets on, and the output voltage will be maintained at 3 volts, and this 3 volts will be continue up to the negative peak. That means up to minus 10 volts, we are going to maintain the output voltage at 3 volts. Output voltage will be maintained at 3 volts. Okay, when after this time period, after this negative peak, what about the input voltage? Okay, in this cycle, that means when this one is on, diode is on, again capacitor will be going to be charged. Okay, and output voltage will be maintained constant. And this is negative cycle. Okay, therefore here voltage will be minus 10. That means this will be minus 10 mil, and this will be plus 10 mil. Okay. Therefore, this minus and this is minus, okay? Now, these two are not in series. These two are not in series connection. Therefore, we may get the output voltage as output voltage when after this voltage, okay? Suppose if we have a voltage at 9 volts, okay? If we have a minus 9 volts, okay? You may have the minus half minus. Because these both are not series, they may get the potential difference, minus half minus. Therefore, you may have the plus 5 volts, okay? The resonant voltage will be plus 5 volts, okay? Now, that may be if the input voltage is increasing linearly, output voltage also increases with respect to the input, okay? When it reaches to the peak value, okay? When it reaches to zero, once again, when it reaches to the, has similar to the previous one, when the input voltage reaches to 0 volts, the output may reaches to the 10 volts, okay? Your peak value 10. This will be your peak, okay? It will be at 10 volts, okay? Well, once again, when the input voltage is positive cycle, when input voltage is positive cycle, diode gets off once again, okay? Therefore, input voltage plus the capacitor voltage, again, it will be charged. Again, it will be charged, and again, it reaches to the 13 volts. Again, it will reach 13 volts, and again, it will be reaches to the decreases, and again, it will be 3 volts. Therefore, your output voltage will be like this. If we observe, initially it may start from 3 and reaches to 13 volts, and again reaches to 3 volts, again 13 volts, okay? Therefore, your output is going to be clamped with reference to 3 volts, okay? If it is a positive clamper, you are going to get the output has like this, 0 to 0, okay? You are going to clamping at 0. That means peak to peak 10 means this value will be at 10 volts, okay? This will be 10 volts, and it may be clipped at 0, okay? If we place a reference voltage, then this voltage will be shifted. This voltage will be shifted to the 3 volts. And the whatever the portion what it has shifted, it may goes to the 13 volts. Okay, it may goes to the 13 volts. Like this, you are going to get. Okay. Therefore, the waveform will be start from 3 and it may goes to the peak value of 13. Okay, like that. Okay. Same fashion as your square previous without reference value, but only the DC level, okay, the DC level in the clamping circuit is going to be changed, okay, the DC level, previous one DC level will be exactly at 15, that means 10 means exactly it will be at 5, okay, Okay, now it will be 5 + 3. That means 8 volts. Okay, at 8 volts you may have the DC level. Okay, that DC level is going to be changed. That means the by adding the reference voltage, by adding the reference voltage to the clamping circuit, we can change the DC level. Okay, DC level in the circuit is going to be changed. Okay, this is the difference between with reference and without reference. Okay, here if we observe the without reference, the waveform is starting from zero. Okay, from zero. If we place a reference voltage some 3 volts, the waveform starts from 3. Okay, the waveform will be starts from 3. Okay, remaining portion will be same. Remaining portion will be same. If we interchange this battery, previously we may start at 3. Now it may start at -3. Okay, because we had applied -3 volts. Okay, suppose if we assume here you are interchanging the battery, and if we apply 3 volts, that means we had applied -3 volts. Diode will be on. Diode will be on when the voltage is less than -3. Okay, therefore your waveform may be starts from -3, starts from -3, and it may continue like this. That means you may have the negative pulse also. Okay, that means if you interchange the polarities, you may get the peak value at -3, like this. Okay, you may get the this peak value will be at -3. Okay, it will be at -3. Okay, like this you are going to get. Okay. If we place the positive voltage, okay, if we place the positive voltage +3 volts, then you may get the waveform from +3, okay, and it may goes up like this. You are going to get +3 means you may get a shifted by 3 volts. -3 means you may have the negative peak. Okay, the waveform stops from. This is the transient portion. We are not interested to give this waveform. Okay, from here onwards your actual output. Okay, this is your actual output. Steady state output. Okay, therefore it may starts from 3. It may starts from 3 if you are applying a positive reference voltage. Okay, this is regarding your reference voltage. If we apply a reference voltage, what happens? Okay, in examination you have to take the waveform. In general they may not ask the input. Okay, therefore you can consider the square wave or sinusoidal. Okay, if they mention the type of the input also, then you have to explain with that waveform only. Okay, because in syllabus we have a topic like different inputs. Okay, clamping circuit with different inputs. Generally we may go for a square wave or sinusoidal waveform. Okay, accordingly you only have to think that when the diode will be on, when the diode will be off. When the diode is on, yeah, the in charging path, if there is a resistance, then the time constant will be very large. Capacitor won't discharge. Okay, suppose if diode is off, then this input voltage and capacitor voltage both will be discharges through this one. Okay, through this resistance. Therefore, the voltage stored in the capacitor won't discharge quickly. The time constant is very large. Okay, if suppose in charging path also, if there is a resistance, then it takes the more time. It won't charge quickly. Okay, when the diode is on. Okay, when the diode is on, this is our charging path. Okay, this is our charging path. Okay, from 3 volts our capacitor is going to charge. In this path there is no resistance, therefore the capacitor charges to the peak value. Okay, capacitor charges to the peak value. Somebody has unmuted their mic. I will mute it. Okay, 241. Okay, fine. If in the circuit there is a resistance, then this capacitor will take the more time. This capacitor will take the more time to charge. That is the assumption we have taken while discussing. Okay, at the time of starting of this topic, we have assumed that time constant is very large. Okay, if the time constant is very large means if there is a resistance in the path of charging or discharging, okay, then the capacitor won't discharge quickly. Okay. If there is no resistance, then the time constant is zero. Okay, if there is no resistance, that means when diode is on, it will be charged in this path, there is no resistance. When diode is off, the capacitor discharges in this path. The capacitor will be discharged in this path. That means in that discharging path, we have a resistance. Therefore, the time constant is R into C, which will be very large. Okay, we have to choose like that. Here, this resistance value should be very large, so that RC value will be very large. Okay. Therefore, the capacitor discharges very slowly. Capacitor discharges very slowly. Okay, while charging, there is no resistance. Therefore, it quickly charges to the peak value. Quickly, it will charges to the peak value. Okay, this is regarding your fast to clamper. Okay, next we will go for the negative clamper. Okay, in negative clamper, only the difference is diode. Okay, without reference voltage, with the reference voltage. This is the reference voltage. Okay, both the cases, when compared with positive clamper and negative clamper, only the change is diode. Okay, diode has to be reverse. Okay, in positive clamper, cathode is on top side, anode is at bottom side. Now it is reverse. Okay, this by reversing this diode, we are getting a negative clamping. Okay, once if we observe the output waveform, okay, the complete waveform is in the negative side. It is clamped to the negative, and this is your DC level. Okay, the minus Vm. Okay, minus Vm is your DC level. Okay, the peak to peak may have the Vm. Therefore, the peak value will be 2 Vm. Peak value will be 2 Vm. Okay, if we come to the explanation, when you are in positive cycle, when you are in positive cycle, this diode will be on. Okay, when diode is on means this will be short circuited. Therefore, your capacitor will charge. With this will be a positive voltage, a positive diode. The capacitor, because this is the positive, okay, in positive cycle, and this will be negative. Current will be entered in this direction. Therefore, this will be a positive plate, and this will be negative plate. And capacitor will charges to the peak value because there is no resistance in this part. Okay, time constant is zero. Okay, time constant is zero. Therefore, capacitor will charges to the peak value. That is Vm. Capacitor will charges to the peak value Vm, and the output voltage in this period, that means in positive cycle, output period will be zero. Okay, therefore in positive cycle you may get the output. This may be goes in transient. That's why we didn't show in our output waveform. Okay, first 1 or 2 seconds, that means we are the steady state of the output we will get after few cycles. Okay, in clamper circuit initially you won't get the steady state. Okay, after few cycles we are going to get the steady state. Okay, generally we are going to draw the steady state waveform only. Okay, if we are explaining, okay, I am considering this transient portion also. Okay, therefore in the first one, first cycle, that means when you apply a positive cycle, this is your first cycle. In first cycle, the output voltage will be zero. Okay, output voltage will be zero. Okay, and when you apply the negative cycle, this diode gets reversed by ourselves. Diode gets reversed by ourselves, and negative cycle means this will be negative and this will be positive. So plus is connected to the minus. That means these two voltages are in series. These two voltages are series, and here you may have the minus terminal. And this will be in plus terminal. Therefore, we are getting the minus 2 Vm, minus 2 Vm in the negative cycle. Okay, that is nothing but from here. Okay, suppose this is your positive cycle. Okay, in negative cycle, what will be the output? In negative cycle, output will be minus 2 Vm. Okay, we are going to get minus 2 Vm. Actually, our input is Vm only. This is your input voltage. Okay, the small waveform is the input voltage, but we are going to get the output as minus 2 Vm. Minus 2 Vm. Okay, and capacitor won't discharge quickly because in this path, okay, we have a resistance. Time constant is very low. Therefore, it will maintain almost a constant voltage of Vm, or slightly it may reduce. Okay, again, when you come to the positive cycle, what happens? This is a positive and this is the negative. And the capacitor will be maintained the same polarity. That means the minus is connected to your anode. Okay, minus is connected to the anode, and cathode is connected to the minus Vm. Okay, cathode is at minus Vm. Okay, anode is at capacitor voltage. Okay, and it is also a minus value. Okay, but this value, okay, capacitor in previous cycle, it may, suppose this may be a 10 volts. Okay, it may drop by 1 volt. It may be dropped by 1 volt. That means it may be at 9.9 volts. Okay, anode side you may have the 9.9, cathode side you may have the 10 volts. Therefore, diode will be still in our reverse bias only. And what are these two voltages? These two voltages will be again start producing at the output terminal. Therefore, again it will minus 3 is connected here. Therefore, you may have a complete negative cycle only, because the capacitor negative terminal is connected here. Yeah, therefore, here negative cycle, both voltages accordingly will be added, and we are going to get at the output terminal. Both voltages we are going to get at the output terminal. Yeah, that means from here again it will start. If the input is increasing, Yeah, this is a positive voltage and this is a negative voltage. Both will be added, and we may get a reducing voltage. Output will be reduces. Yeah, and it may reaches when the input reaches to the peak value. It may reaches to the negative peak. Okay, it may reaches to the negative peak. Okay, when input is increasing, again it will be increases. Okay, so that like this you are going to get the output terminal. Okay, therefore here from up to this point, we can consider as a transient. Okay, that I have not shown here. Okay, from here onwards, we are going. That means from the second cycle onwards, we are going to show the output waveform. Okay, therefore we are getting the a complete negative waveform. Okay, therefore diode is clamped at the negative cycle. Okay, if we apply a reference voltage, again it will be shifted. Okay, if it is a positive reference, it will be shifted bottom. Okay, suppose if I apply some reference voltage, some 10 volts or 9 volts, okay, it will start from here. Okay, like this we are going to get. Okay, that means instead of starting at the zero level, or instead of starting at peak value, it may start somewhere at the reference value. Okay, reference value, and again it may continue. Okay, like this, it may you are going to get the output voltage. Okay, simple explanation. Okay, what whether diode is on or off. Okay, if we assume like that, you are going to get the output waveforms. Okay, what are the cycle? Okay, whether it is a positive reference, I have taken the negative reference also. Okay. As I said previously, this is a positive clipper. Okay, positive clipper with a negative reference. Okay, therefore we are getting some portion in negative cycle also. Okay, this is a positive clipper. Okay, observe the positive clipper and negative clipper. This is a negative clipper. Okay, negative clamper, not clipper. Negative clamper. Okay, negative clamper anode is top side. Okay, for a positive clamper, a cathode is on the top side. Okay, for a positive clamper. We have applied the negative reference voltage. If we apply negative reference voltage, then what happens? We may get a negative value also, negative portion. Okay, we are getting some negative portion. Okay, if we apply only the positive reference voltage, complete waveform will be above the reference value. Okay, above the positive. Now suppose if we apply positive reference, this is my reference voltage. Okay, your output waveform will be like this. Okay, output waveform will be like this. Okay. You are going to having above the reference. If it is a negative reference, this is the negative reference. Therefore, our output voltage will be above the negative reference. We are getting some negative portion also. Okay, this is the if we interchange the battery. If we interchange the reference voltage, then this type of waveforms you are going to get at the output terminals. Okay, the explanation will be same. Okay, clippers no, we don't need to matter no. Okay, the explanation will be. As similar, okay, when the diode is on or off. When it is on, what about the capacitor charging and what about the voltage at the output terminals? Okay, therefore, this is regarding to your clamper circuits. Okay, in clamper circuits, they may ask the basically they may ask the a positive clamper or negative clamper with the different voltages. Okay, generally, we may restrict it with the positive reference voltage only. Okay. Next, if they want to tighten your paper, then they will go for the negative reference voltage. Okay, that's why I have shown one negative reference voltage also. This is your negative reference voltage. Okay, so whatever maybe you have to keep in mind, if you add the reference voltage, output waveform will be above the reference value. Okay, above the difference. If you want to add the reference voltage, then the output voltage will be above the zero level. Above the this zero. Zero is the your reference voltage. Okay. Above this zero or below this zero, okay, it will be maintained. Okay, positive clipper means the waveform will be above the zero. If it is a negative clipper, below the zero. Okay, if we add the reference voltage, then it will be above the reference value or below the reference value. Okay, like that you are going to get. Okay, the instead of this zero line, the zero line will be shifted to the reference line. Okay, if you remember this one, drawing the output waveform will be very easy. Without by-harding or without if you miss the concept also, you can draw the output waveform correctly. Okay, that means I explain how to draw the output waveform. If it is a positive clipper, Okay, it is a sorry false to clamper. Then without reference voltage is zero. Then your output waveform will be a zero is the reference voltage. Okay, because there is no reference voltage. Therefore, like this, you are going to get the output waveform. If we have a positive reference voltage, okay, positive reference voltage, let it be this one. Okay, a positive reference voltage, then the output will be above this difference value, above this difference voltage, above this difference voltage. Like this, you are going to get. If we have a negative reference voltage, okay, where it is a positive clamper, therefore it will be above this negative reference. That means you may get some negative portion also. Okay, you are going to get some negative portion. Like this, you are going to get. Okay, it will be above your, because it is a positive clamper. Okay, the waveform should be in positive side. Okay, therefore here we have applied the negative reference voltage. Therefore, the waveform will be in positive side only. Okay, that is above this difference. We may get some negative spikes. Okay, or negative portion. Okay, we are going to get some negative portion. Okay, similarly, if it is a negative clamper, if it is a negative clamper, means without reference voltage, means entire waveform will be on the negative side with zero, as zero line has the reference. Okay, zero line has the reference. Like this, you are going to get. If we have a positive reference voltage, that means this is your positive reference voltage, the output will be you may have some positive portion like this. Okay, below the reference value. Okay, the waveform will be, because it is a negative clamper, waveform should be present on the negative side, but we have used the positive reference. Therefore, the reference line, instead of zero, it may changes to this value. Okay, this is your positive reference. If we have a negative reference, okay, then the waveform will be below this one, below this point. Okay, below the negative reference. Okay, if you forgot the concept, if you miss the concept also, directly you can draw the output waveform. Okay, if you remember this point. Okay, always in positive clamper, the waveform will be in positive side. Negative clamper, the waveform will be on negative side. Okay, negative clamper, the waveform will be on negative side. If you remember this point, okay, if you remember this point, then it will be easy to draw the output waveform. Okay, if you miss the concept also. Okay, here we are not considering any transient portions. Okay, previously, for 1 or 2 cycles, 1 or 2 cycles, the waveform may not be look like this. Okay, those may be a transient portion. Okay, for 1 or 2 cycles, you may not get the output. Okay, the whole clamper circuit will be, we will get the output after 1 or 2 seconds. Okay, immediately you won't get the clamper circuit. Okay, and one more point here you have to remember is, here it is a capacitor. Okay, capacitor won't allow the sudden changes in voltage. Suppose if we apply a square wave, we are writing the output waveform as similar to this. That means I am saying in steady state, we are writing the output has a flat top. Okay, flat. Okay, it may be a straight line. Okay. Yeah, but this capacitor won't allow like this. Okay, sudden changes won't. That means if you go for practical clamper, as you seen in a high pass circuit, okay, you may get some tilt like this. Okay, in negative also like this. Okay, you once again will draw. Okay, like this we may get the output. Okay, up to now we have discussed that. The output will be like this. I will represent in dotted lines. Okay, this is your actual. Up to now we have discussed it. Okay, up to now the output will be like this. We have discussed it. Okay, but when you go for practical, you won't get this type of waveforms. Okay, you won't get the straight waveforms. Okay, like these pulses you won't get. Okay, you may get your output may be like this. Your output may be like this. Okay, as you know, your high pass circuit. Okay. Why? Because the capacitor is an exponential device. Okay, it will charge exponentially and discharges exponentially. We have not considered that point also. Okay, up to now in our discussion, we have not considered that point. And also this resistance and this supply. What are the supply we have? Okay, this both will have some finite resistance. Okay, when diode is on, the forward resistance will be present here. Okay, generally this forward resistance is very small. Okay, forward resistance is very small. This is your road resistance. If the road resistance is some 1 kilo ohm, okay, road resistance is 1 kilo ohm, and if we have a diode forward, the diode is on condition, Now diode forward resistance, let it be 100 ohms. Okay, let it be 100 ohms. Then if you want to have the reference voltage, if you want to use the reference voltage, then in this case two resistances are in parallel. Two resistances are in parallel. One is small resistance, one is large resistance. Okay, you went two resistances are in parallel. Okay, one is large resistance, one is small resistance. Then resultant value. Okay, resultant resistance value will be the small resistance. Okay, you can check it. Okay, 100 ohms were parallel with 1 kilo. Okay, if you check it, then you may get some 110 ohms. Like that you may get. Okay, if it is in series. Okay, if two resistors are in series, one is smaller, one is large, 100 ohms and 1 kilo ohm, then you may get 1.1K. Okay, you may get the larger value. Okay, in parallel, you may get the smaller value. That means the resultant resistance is going to be changed here. It may change your output waveform. Okay, it may change your output, even though this resistance, what are the, we may call it as a source resistance. Okay, the source resistance will be also in series. Okay, for these parameters, we have to consider. Okay, all these parameters may change your output waveform. Okay, it may not be as similar to what we have seen now. Okay. Up to now, what we have seen the waveforms, in practical case, we may not get like this. Okay, it may be some deviated. Okay, it may be deviated from these ideal cases. Okay, up to now, we have discussed the ideal cases. Why I am saying this point means we have a concept of practical clippers, practical clampers. Okay, we have a concept practical clampers. Okay, while we are going for a practical clampers, we have to consider all these points. Okay. There will be a source resistance. The diode is on, means there will be a diode forward resistance. When diode is off, okay, diode is off means reverse bias. Reverse bias general up to now we have taken as an open circuit. Okay, but in reverse bias also you may have some resistance. Okay, which is high value. Okay, the reverse bias resistance is very high. It will be in mega ohms. In reverse bias we may have the mega ohms resistance. Okay. When mega ohm is parallel with kilo ohms, our load resistance is in kilo ohms, suppose. Okay, the resultant resistance will be mega ohms. Okay, the resultant. Okay, 1 mega parallel with 1 kilo. Okay, resultant will be 1 mega. Okay, you may have some 998 kilo ohms. Okay, which may be near to the mega ohms. Okay, therefore, when a large resistance and a small resistance is parallel, you may have a small resistance. Okay, you may have near to the small resistance. Okay. These are parameters you have to consider while you are considering the a practical clamper circuit. Okay, that I will show it now. I will open another slide, not in this PPT. Wait a minute, we opened a new slide, new PPT. Okay, this one, the clamper circuit with diode and source resistance. Okay, that means if you go for practical case, for this source we may have some source resistance. Similarly, when diode will be on, this is our load resistance. Okay, this is our load resistance. And when diode is on, okay, first we may take the diode is in on state. Okay, when diode is on, and then we may have the forward bias resistance. This is the load resistance, and this is your forward bias resistance. Okay, this is your load resistance RL, and this is your forward bias resistance. These two are in parallel now. Okay, when these two are in parallel, then the resultant will be smaller resistance. That is your forward resistance. Okay, This is the forward resistance is very small. Okay, you can see here forward resistance is very small. Therefore, you may have the resultant resistance will be very small. Okay, forward resistance will be in ohms. Okay, it may be 100 ohms or 150 ohms. Okay, if suppose if the load resistance is 1 kilo ohm or 2 kilo ohms, then the combination will be an in ohms. Okay, combination may get in ohms. Okay, therefore this will be your equivalent circuit. Okay. That means this can be redrawn as like this. This is your source resistance. This is your load resistance. Okay, which is your forward resistance. Okay, similarly, when diode is off, you may have a reverse bias resistance. Okay, you may have the reverse bias resistance. This is your reverse bias resistance. Okay, therefore, here also reverse bias resistance is very large. Okay, reverse bias we may have in mega ohms. Okay, it may be in mega ohms. Okay, it is in kilo ohms. Our load resistance is kilo ohms. Okay. Therefore, when you combination these two, you may get a kilo ohms. That means you may have the R. R is your resonant resistance. Okay. Here also, this is the equivalent circuit. Okay. You can go for the equivalent circuit. Therefore, these parameters, okay, all these parameters is going to affecting your waveform. Okay. Going to affecting your waveform. And practical clamping circuit, you may get the output like this. Okay. Up to now, okay. This is with the reference voltage. Okay. With the reference, it is shifted by some volt, therefore you may consider as a reference voltage. After all, you may consider like this, okay? Like this, we have considered, okay? We may have the flat top, okay? We are not considered the capacitor effect or with this resistance effect that is not considered, and we may take the like this, but practically, you may get like this, okay? It may be somewhat as similar to a high pass circuit or low pass circuit, okay? In high pass circuit, we have seen, okay, like a tilt, we have derived the formula for tilt also, okay, like that, you are going to get the output waveforms, okay, this is your practical circuit, okay. In exam, if they may ask the practical clamper circuit, then you have to explain all these concepts, okay, you have to explain the source resistance, diode forward resistance, capacitor factor, okay, all these factors, and if you take the square wave, ideally, you make it like this. But practically, you may get some flat top, okay, at least on the top of this square wave. Like this, you have to explain, okay. These points you have to keep in mind, okay, because it is not an practical, okay, it is not an ideal case, okay, it is a practical case, okay. Therefore, all these points you have to remember. So this is regarding your practical clamper, okay. It may be a positive or it may be a negative, whatever may be. There is no difference in practical. If you are considering ideal, you may get a smooth waveforms. Okay, if you are practical, you may not get the smooth waveforms. Okay, there we may get some distortions. Okay, and next one, very very important concept, clamping circuit theorem. Okay, clamping circuit theorem. Okay, they may ask for 2 marks bit. Okay, short answers. Okay, if derivation they may ask, they may go for the 4 marks or 5 marks bit. Okay, very very important clamping circuit theorem. Okay, what this clamping circuit theorem says means under steady state. That means this theorem has said under steady state. We are not considering the transient portion. Okay, under steady state, the forward wave, here I write the definition statement. Once see this statement. Okay, the area under the forward bias condition and the area under the reverse bias condition are related as. Okay, that means it says that. The ratio of area under forward bias to ratio of reverse bias is equal to the R is nothing but resistance. Resistance under forward bias to the resistance under reverse bias. Okay, you may take R suffix smaller. Okay, R suffix smaller. Okay, that means what this statement says means, up to now. Okay, up to now we have seen the practical clamper circuit. We have seen the practical clamper circuit. I am taking those waveforms, okay, a practical clamping circuit, this is like this, okay, wait a minute. Okay, like this, you may get the output terminal, okay, like this, you may get the output terminal, okay, what it says means, the area under, this is in this cycle, first cycle, the diode may be in forward bias. Now, if we assume it is a positive clamper, okay, positive clamper means negative clamper, what happens, diode will be like this, okay, diode will be like this and it may be connected to your capacitor. In positive cycle, diode is in on position, diode will be in on position, negative cycle, diode will be off position, okay, diode will be in reverse bias. That means Yeah, first second diode is on, we may get like this. If I apply a square wave, square wave has an input. Okay, I had applied a square wave as an input so that the practical clamper, I have taken the practical clamper so that I may get like this waveform. Okay, now what this statement says means the area under the positive cycle. Okay, that means when diode is in forward bias. Okay, when diode is in forward bias, okay, the area under this portion to the area under reverse bias, area under the reverse bias. Okay, these two portions, okay, if you take the ratio, it will be equal to the forward bias resistance. Okay, forward bias resistance by reverse bias resistance. Okay, forward bias resistance by reverse bias resistance. Okay, I think so. This may be somewhere wrong. We will prove it. Okay, it may be a reverse bias by forward bias. Okay, we will prove once again. What it says means it is the ratio of area, under the forward bias to the reverse bias will be equal to the resistance, of the diode. Okay, ratio of the resistance, forward bias resistance divided by the reverse bias resistance. Okay, therefore that this diode is going to offering some resistance in forward bias. Okay, that one, and this diode is going to offering the some resistance in reverse bias also. Okay, this ratio, okay, it should be ratio should be a, if you take the ratio, this ratio and the area ratio, if you take the area of this curve, okay, area of the curve, that would be some AF, okay, forward bias area AF, reverse bias area AR, okay, these two will be equal. That's the clamping theorem says. Okay, once again, clamping theorem says under steady state, area under forward bias condition will be equal to the area, area under the forward bias and the area under reverse bias are related as, okay, this is the area under forward bias and reverse bias, it may be related as in terms of resistance, okay, RF by RR, okay, like that it may be related, okay, very, very important derivation, important statement, okay, definitely they are going to ask for short bit, okay, 2 marks bit, okay. Definitely this in this chapter this question defined clamping circuit theorem will be damn sure. Okay, you have to remember this statement. Okay, now coming to the proof, okay, we will derive it. Okay, here I have taken directly the charge. Okay, directly charge under positive cycle, charge under negative cycle. Okay, yeah, if they may ask for 4 marks or 5 marks bit, you can add one more step for this one. Okay, when diode is on, okay, this is under Q1 is nothing but a charge under diode is on condition, Q2 is nothing but charge under the diode is off condition. Okay, you hear well, for a forward bias condition, when the forward bias means diode is on, when diode is on, the current flowing in the circuit, okay, the current, that means you can take the positive or negative camp, you can draw it. Okay, when diode is on state, okay, you can take the positive or negative, whatever may be. Here I am not mentioning the input voltage, okay, simply on condition. Okay, that means a positive cycle, this is a positive clipper. Okay, this is a positive clipper, diode will be on in negative cycle, this is a negative clipper, negative clamper. Okay, you should not confuse between clamper and clipper. Okay, the negative clamper, diode will be on in positive cycle. This will be on in positive cycle, this will be on in negative cycle. Okay, therefore I have not mentioned the input whether it is a positive cycle or negative. Simply I have taken when the diode is on condition. When diode is on, current flowing in the cycle, current flowing in the circuit, let it be I. It is in forward bias, therefore I may take IF of t. Okay, I may consider as that IF of t. The current in this circuit, that means if we okay, sorry for inconvenience. When diode is on, okay, that means it may be a positive cycle and positive clamper and negative clamper. Okay, that means the capacitor and we may have a forward resistance here. Okay, we may have the forward resistance. Diode is we have a road resistance also here. Here, road resistance is parallel combination with forward resistance. Therefore, these two will be combined. These two will be combined, and we may have a forward resistance here. Okay, we may have the forward resistance only. Okay, that means when diode is on, your current in the circuit will be nothing but a voltage divided by resistance. Voltage divided by this, the resistance is nothing but your forward resistance. Therefore, IF, okay, forward bias. Okay, I had taken suffix F means your diode is in forward bias. IF of T, because it is a time wave, because we have a capacitor. Okay, capacitor will change the current linearly, okay, exponentially. Here there will be a change in voltage, correspondingly there will be a change in current. Therefore, it is a time-varying current. IF of T equal to, simply you can write as voltage. In forward bias, you may have the VR. VR of T divided by RF. Okay, forward resistance. Okay, that is nothing but a, and we know the charge. Okay, we know the charge. If you want to find out the charge in positive cycle, that means in positive cycle, we may get this type of waveform. Okay, let it be time period will be zero, and this will be at T1. Up to the time period T1, we may have the positive cycle. Therefore, the charge Q, okay, in positive cycle, we may get simply by integrating the current zero to time period T1. Okay, if we integrate this one, the R is constant. Therefore, 1 by RF will be outside, and we may have the VR of T. Okay, integral of VR of T, that means this waveform. Okay, for this waveform, yeah, we are integrating this portion. Okay, if we make integrate, if we are going to integrating any curve, we are going to get the area. Okay, for a certain time period, okay, 0 to T1, we are integrating. This is our voltage waveform. Okay, VR. Okay, in positive cycle. Okay, in positive cycle, we are going to get this type of waveform. Therefore, you are going to get integrating this one. If we integrate this this portion, 0 to T1, this portion, we are going to get the area. Therefore, this charge can be written as area in forward bias by resistance. That, like that, we get this waveform. Okay, this equation. Okay, this equation, how we get? Simple derivation. Okay, current, we had taken forward bias current. Forward bias current is nothing, voltage by resistance. We may draw this circuit. Okay, for you, in order to get the mole marks. Okay, directly I have write this step here. If suppose they may ask for mole marks as an essay question, you have to elaborate. Okay, simply draw the forward bias circuit. Okay, forward bias clamper circuit. Okay, simply we have the capacitor and forward bias resistance here. Forward bias resistance here, and simply current is nothing but voltage by resistance, and you want to find out the charge. Okay, charge is nothing but the integration of current. Okay, if you make the integration of current, you are going to get the charge. Therefore, for a time period 0 to T1, because for T1 period, diode is on position. Okay, I can write here the forward bias condition for the time period 0 less than T less than T1. Okay, T1. Okay, this is my forward biasing time period. If I consider like that, then in this time period, I am going to integrating the current. If I integrate the current, I am going to get 1 by RF integral 0 to T1. VR of T. Okay, this is if we integrate any curve, VR is this curve. Okay, if we integrate this one, we are going to get the area. Therefore, we can write the forward area divided by forward resistance. This is in the forward cycle. Okay, in reverse bias. Okay, in reverse bias, capacitor will be discharging. Okay, diode will be off. Diode will be off, and capacitor will be discharging. In reverse bias, we may have the reverse bias resistance. Okay, reverse bias means the two resistances are in parallel. Okay, this is my reverse bias resistance VR, and we may have the road resistance R. This is our road resistance. As we seen in previous, okay, when the reverse bias will be in mega ohms, therefore, when you have a road resistance will be in kilo ohms. When you have a parallel combination, we have only R as the resultant resistance. Okay, that's why you have taken here R. Okay. Reverse bias means V gamma. We may consider as a reverse bias resistance as a V gamma. Okay, this will be very large. It will be in mega ohms. Okay, parallel combination will be, both will be a small resistance. Therefore, the resonance circuit will be capacitance with your road resistance R. Okay, this is the road resistance, and here we may have the diode forward bias resistance. Okay, RF. This is the diode forward bias resistance. That is the smaller value. Okay. Therefore, in on position, you may have circuit like this. In off position, you may have circuit like this. Okay. For this one also, same process. Current is nothing but a voltage by reverse bias voltage. The reverse bias voltage means I can take as VR, okay, or V gamma. Okay, reverse bias voltage divided by reverse bias resistance. Resistance is nothing but the R. Here we have a resistance of R. Therefore, if we make integration, we may get the area in the negative the reverse bias cycle. That means this one, okay, reverse bias cycle you are going to get. Okay, not flat. It may be somewhat like this. Okay, therefore this area you are going to calculate. Okay, for the interval of some T1 to T2, this may be a T1 and this time period may be T2. Therefore, you may get integral T1 to T2 V R of T or V gamma of T. Okay, this is the area of this curve. Okay, therefore you may get area of the reverse bias divided by R. Okay, now under steady state, charged, the capacitor charge should be equal to capacitor discharge. Okay, capacitor charge should be equal to capacitor discharge. Therefore, you may have the AF by RF should be equal to AR by R. Okay, if you make a cross multiplication, okay, this will be right only. If you make a cross multiplication, you may get the AF by AR equal to RF by R. Okay, therefore, this is your clamping circuit theorem. Okay, clamping circuit, you make a class multiplication. Okay, if you make a class multiplication, you may get this will becomes here and this may go here. Okay, therefore, AF by AR equal to, you may get the RF by R. Okay, therefore, this is your clamping circuit. Very, very important one. Very easy derivation also. Okay, but in exam, you have to make some elaboration. Okay. Here directly I have taken the steps. Okay, charge I have taken directly and here I have equated. But how this charge is going to get means by using the current equation. Okay, current is nothing but a voltage by resistance. If you make integration of this one, you may get the charge. Charge is nothing but integral I dt. Okay, this may be our charge. Okay, from this concept we have derived this formula and this equation. Okay, AF by RF. Okay, similarly in here also. Okay, here you have to, in exam you have to mention why you have taken R, why you have taken RF. Okay, why you have taken R and RF means from the previous topic. Okay, from the previous topic you will get the knowledge of this one. Okay, when diode is on, you consider the forward bias resistance. Okay, then the forward bias resistance will be smaller value, and when compared with the load resistance, therefore resultant will be smaller value. Okay, when diode is off, reverse bias resistance will be very large. Okay, it will be generally mega ohms. Okay, therefore parallel combination you may have the load resistance. Okay, where R, you can take R or RL. Okay, it may be a load resistance. Okay, this will be load resistance. Therefore, the clamping circuit theorem says that area under forward bias to the area under reverse bias should be equal to the forward bias resistance. Okay, forward bias resistance to the load resistance. Okay, to the load resistance, or it may be a circuit resistance. Okay, equivalent circuit resistance. Okay, this is your clamping circuit theorem says. Okay, very, very important concept. This clamping circuit theorem is very, very important. Okay, next one we will see the what will be the effect. Okay, a simple derivation. Last topic in our clamping nonlinear wave shaping. Okay, the effect of diode characteristics. Okay, this is also as similar to our clamping circuit. Very simple derivation which you have seen in your EDC. Okay, this equation. Okay, now I am not concentrating to derive this equation. This derivation, current equation through the diode, which you have seen in your EDC. Okay, once we call this equation. Okay, current through the diode. Okay, this is nothing but I naught into e power VCL by eta into we may call eta as a Boltzmann's constant or something, okay, into Vt. Okay, this equation we have seen in our EDC. Okay, from this equation we are going to derive, okay, simply this V dash. Okay, this is nothing but our voltage levels. Okay, our input voltage levels. Okay, I will draw it neatly, our input waveform. Okay, this level they may call it as an V1 and this may be a V double dash. Okay, positive or negative. Okay, resultant when the charge in the capacitor, the charging of the capacitor resistance voltage is equal to that is nothing but upper voltage minus lower voltage, okay, Vm minus V double dash, that is nothing but this one. From this one we are going to calculating the VCL. Okay, we are taking the VCL simply ICL by I naught, and if you take the logarithm ln, you may get the VCL. Okay, VCL. Okay, from this equation VCL is nothing but first we may take the ICL by I naught. Okay, and if you take the ln, so that E under ln get cancelled, and we may get the VCL divided by eta into VT. Okay, and VC is nothing but this may get, therefore finally we may get eta into VT the ln of ICL by I naught. Okay, where ICL by I naught is nothing but the current. Okay, therefore voltage by resistance, we have taken the voltage by resistance. Therefore this, if you take I into this side, you may get V by RI. Okay, you take in derivation from this equation, you can say that the output voltage, okay, output voltage may depend upon your diode parameters. Okay, output voltage, this is output voltage equation, it may depends upon the diode parameters. Okay, where eta or VT, okay, these are the diode parameters. Okay, therefore depending on the diode characteristics, the output voltage is going to be changed. Okay, it may be very simple if you remember this equation. Okay, this equation we have seen in our EDC. Okay, from that equation we have taken, okay, we have rewritten this equation. We are rewriting this equation, and from that equation we are going to say that it is depending upon the diode parameters. Therefore output waveform is going to change depending upon the diode characteristics. Okay, no need this, by simple common sense we can say that if diode is an silicon diode or germanium diode, okay, definitely there will be 0.3 or 0.7 cutoff voltage. Accordingly the output waveform is going to be changed. Here for the diode there will be an some temperature parameters, okay, junction parameters, junction barriers, okay, depending on these parameters, all these parameters is going to change the output waveform. Okay, simply we have a topic, that's why they have done some derivation. Okay, simple derivation. Okay, I think so it may not be much more important. This is regarding your non-linear wave shaping. Okay, briefly, we have a time still another 10 minutes. Therefore, simply I may recall, okay, recall entire concept of your from the starting onwards. Okay, yeah, in this chapter, we have seen the clippers and clampers. Okay, in clippers, we have a diode clippers and transistor clippers. Okay, diode clippers means simply a diode is going to be used here. Okay, diode is going to be used, and by using diode, we are going to cutting our waveform. Okay, simply we are going to cut the positive portion, or we can cut the negative portion. Okay, simply we are removing some part. Okay, in clipper, we are removing some portion of the waveform. Okay, we are coming to the clamper circuit. In clamper, we are not removing any waveform. Simply we are shifting the zero level. We are shifting the zero level. That's the first point. Okay, difference between these two. Okay, here we are removing some portion of the waveform. Okay, here we won't remove anything. In clamper, you have to remember that the peak to peak value won't change. Suppose the input value is from 10 volts to 10 volts. That means this may be positive 10 and this may be minus 10. Then your output voltage will be 0 to 20 volts. Okay, output voltage will be some 0 to 20 volts. Okay, that means in clamper circuit, peak to peak, here peak to peak also 10 minus of minus 10, totally 20 volts. We have a peak to peak value is, this is your peak to peak. Peak to peak, we have a 20 volts. Here also peak to peak, okay. It may be a 0 level and it may be a 20 level. Here peak to peak, we have the 20 volts. Peak to peak value is 20 volts, okay. Therefore, there won't be any change in the peak to peak. Peak to peak value will be constant. Okay, this is the first point you have to observe. Okay, there won't be any change in the peak to peak. Only the change is DC level. Here, the DC level in clamper circuit is at zero level. This is your input. Okay, it is at DC level is at zero. Okay, zero level. Okay, and here DC level may be somewhere here. Okay, it may be suppose 0 to 10, 20 means it may be at 10 volts. Okay, this is your zero level. That means zero level above and below. Okay, above and below you may have the equal portion of the waveform. Okay, this is your zero component. For this one, if you find out the four, if you apply the Fourier analysis, definitely you are going to get the A0 value. A0 value has some 10. A0 value has some 10. If this waveform, if you find the DC Fourier analysis, you may get the A0 value has 0. Okay, that means this it will be useful when you are going for the amplifier circuits. Okay, or some receiver circuits, it requires the DC levels. Yeah, there we are going to use this clamper circuits. Okay, and this is nothing but for removing the noise or for giving the input for the amplifier. Okay, generally amplifier the input voltage will be fixed. Okay, if we have a more voltage, then we may cut some portion of the input waveform and we'll give as an input to the amplifiers. Okay, the clippers can be designed by using diodes and transistors. By using these two, we can design. Okay, we have seen the diode, different type of diode clippers. It may be a positive clamper or negative clamper with difference or without difference. We have seen different types. Similarly, for the transistor also, we have seen different types. Okay, for all these one, we have to learn the transfer characteristics and output waveforms. Okay, transfer characteristics and output waveform, and a two level clamper, which may be an emitter coupled. Okay, it is going to cut on the two sides. Okay, that means here also the portion will be cut. Therefore, for this one, output will be like this. Okay, it is cutting here and it is cutting here. Suppose this is your reference wave, okay, zero level. Okay, it is cutting some portion here and some portion here. Okay, therefore it is nothing but two level clipper. We are going to call it as a two level clipper. Okay, emitter coupled is a two level clipper. Okay, simply they may ask the transistor two level clipper, or simply they may ask the emitter coupled. Okay, we can write the both will be same. Okay, similar in clamper circuit, we have seen the practical clamper. Like when you go for the practical clamper, output may not be as smooth as similar. We have discussed in this topic. Okay, clamper circuit with the diodes. Okay, with the different inputs. Okay, we have seen the sinusoidal and the square input. Okay, we have seen that without any distortion. Okay. We are assuming as an ideal diode. Okay, ideal diode and everything we have to consider as an ideal. Okay, so that we get the waveforms. Okay, when coming to the practical, there will be some parameters. Okay, that may be a diode parameters or diode follower resistance or reverse bias resistance or some supply voltage. Okay, these supply source resistance, we may call it as a source resistance. These factors are going to change your output waveform. Okay, you may not get a flat output pulses. Okay, you may get some tilts in our output waveforms. Okay, all these one we have seen practical and diode characteristics and clamping circuit here. Okay, the transfer clamper circuit nothing but your output waveform, which we have seen when you are discussing the clamper circuit itself. Okay, this is regarding your second chapter. Okay, from tomorrow we will start our third chapter. If we have any doubts, okay, regarding your second chapter, you can rectify. Yeah, I will share this PPT in our WhatsApp group.